El mezcal es el agua bendita con que se bautiza a un niño, la ofrenda que se le hace al santo patrón de un pueblo, la verdad que se le dice al amigo, las lágrimas con que se despiden a un difunto.
Mexico's fiery beverage, mezcal. The agave liquor was long known as a poison of village drunks and the most crazed Americans, but it has recently been reborn as a trendy drink, both in Mexico City and in booming exports to the United States and Europe, bringing in much-needed dollars to the ancient villages where it is made. Global Post went to explore the spirit's comeback.
To check out the crazy mezcal, we've come to Mexico City's historic center. Now this used to be quite a rundown, grimy area, but recently the mayor has put a lot of money in it. It's become a very nice, trendy area with a lot of bars and a lot of mezcalerias. To help us find out about this beverage, we're going to meet an American expat who's been in Mexico for more than 15 years, and he's known locally as quite a mezcal fiend, John Hecht. So John, how you doing?
Hey, funny meeting you here.
Yeah, likewise. So where should we go?
Let's go to La Bota. It's on the other street here, and then we can come back over here and go to El Andar. It's a small little mezcal joint.
What is it about mezcal, do you think, that's made it become so popular recently? How was it real quick with mezcal?
It started like 5 years ago, and I think people, at least in Mexico City, just kind of got tired of drinking tequila all the time. Just the fact that it's an organic drink, in most cases it's organic. So I think people like that, you know, it's not like this commercialized process to make it.
With this, is it best to sip it slowly or drink it hard?
I prefer it slowly. You can have a little bit of orange after that.
A bit of orange, yeah?
Yeah.
Like in tequila you have lemon, in mezcal you have orange, yeah? Very nice. What makes a good mezcal?
Well, there are a lot of proof that you have to know to say if it's a good mezcal. You can put a little bit on your hand, and you have to dry it out, so all the alcohol goes out.
Okay.
And then you have to feel the smoke.
Around the corner at Mezcalería El Andar, owner Mariano has one of the biggest selections of mezcal in the city.
Do you have how many types of mezcal in this bar?
Around 28 sorts, different plants, different states. We go from Oaxaca to Durango, Jalisco, Michoacán. And in Mexico we have like almost 200 different plants to make mezcal. Puntas is very strong. Oh, the other one, 50 degrees of alcohol, still strong for...
So that's 50 degrees alcohol?
Yeah.
And how about this one?
60.
60 degrees?
60 degrees.
So to get a bit deeper into the story of this beverage, we're going to go now and meet somebody who produces mezcal, Salvador Robles, who's got his own brand from Oaxaca. And we're going to meet him over here in a mezcaleria. ¿Cuántos años tenías tú cuando primero probaste el mezcal?
Quizá unos 6, 7 años. eso se puede.
Sí, está bien, sí. Adelante. A los 6, 7 años.
Sí, sí, pero como una curiosidad, o sea, como una, no sé, como una travesura quizá. Los pueblos prehispánicos tenían ese aprovechamiento de los agaves, ¿no? Porque era su entorno natural. Y cuando llegan los españoles, aportan un elemento que es el alambique y que permite elevar la gradación alcohólica de las bebidas. Y actualmente, para las comunidades rurales en México, constituye también una forma de enfrentar fenómenos como la migración o el narcotráfico. Para todo mal, mezcal. Para todo bien, también. Y si no hay remedio, litro y medio.
Qué bueno, ¿no? Pues salud. Vamos a probar esto. He calls his mezcal Pierde Almas, which means losing your soul. And he has here the slogan Otra vez esta maldita felicidad, which you could translate as something like another time that damned happiness.
On location in Mexico City, this is Joan Grillo for Global Post.